What is going on, guys? Stinger back here with more LCPDFR. The GTA 5 has been released today, and I don't have a console. I sold my Xbox 360, nor do I have a PlayStation, so you will not be seeing any GTA 5 gameplay from me. But LCPDFR will stay. And yeah, let's get to this drug deal. I've tried recording this video with the same car and same shit I was gonna talk about for a few days now, but the fucking game kept crashing, and with my recording software, the game crashes while it's recording. The video gets corrupted, and I can no longer use it for anything, and it's just corrupted. And I had like an hour long video for you guys, and then it crashed. Not an hour long, like half an hour, and it crashed. And then I lost all that footage because it got corrupted, regardless if I press the not record button and so on, while it's crashed to the desktop. So it's like, so I was so really fucking pissed. So I reinstalled the game because I fucked it up from installing other shit and stuff. So yeah, motherfucker wouldn't give up. No, but anyways, LCPDFR version 1.0 is coming. So yeah, I'm still gonna be doing LCPDFR. No GTA 5 gameplay for me. It's either a good thing or a bad thing, because I know there's more than enough people doing LCPDFR, but I mean, most are going to do GTA 5 videos for their next few days. Well, me, I can't get GTA 5 regardless, so I'll still be doing LCPDFR. So it'll be a good thing, past the red light. It'll be a good thing in the sense of that people who still want LCPDFR and GTA 5. Like the LCPDFR, the big ones, if they're just filled with just GTA 5 videos, while me, I still have LCPDFR, then they'll most likely watch mine, since there's no other. Well, that's of course if they subscribe to me, but people will most likely watch my videos and their GTA 5 videos, but they'll watch my LCPDFR videos, since most of the other big YouTubers aren't doing it. So that could happen. If it doesn't, then whatever, that's okay. But regardless, I'm still gonna be doing LCPDFR for you guys. So we'll see how this turns out. I am using a gang unit charger for the Scopes Police Department. I did make these skins, not entirely. I did edit them, but since they're for personal use, I am allowed to do it regardless of the author's permission. Okay, he's good. Just gonna give another citation for passing a red light. So yeah, an update on the Scrubs Police Department. It wasn't a clan, it was a little LCPDFR gaming group that I did with a few of my friends, but doesn't want to play LCPDFR no more, and T-Rex doesn't have internet right now. So yeah, and that's it, pretty much just them two who had it and stuff. So yeah. So yeah, the next few videos I'll be using these skins, because I did make them, but I made like one video with them, now this is the second one with them, and you didn't really get to see much in the last one, so, yeah, this is gonna be like the end of watch for the entire Scrubs Police Department, so, yeah. This 2002, another van passing red light.
Pull over now.
Damn. But yeah.
Hello.
Old lady.
Do you know how fast you were going back then? ID papers, please.
Alright. What else?
Thank you.
That's pretty much it for now. I'm trying to do other games, but I don't know. I think I'm just gonna stick to GTA 4 for a while. And of course, when LCPDFR version 1.0 comes out, I'm definitely doing that instantly. Because, yeah. I don't know, but yesterday I got a sense of police pride, and now I have more pride for the police. And I don't know, it's like basically I'm saying I really respect the police. A lot, like more than I used to, and stuff, and role playing as them in GTA is just fun, not in the sense of like of just being the cop, just just being the cop, but not in the sense of just killing innocent people and shit, you know. I'm not like that. I don't want to abuse the mod. I actually want to play it, like, you know, role play as much as I can, because I think that's fun and interesting. So yeah, let's do it. Oh yeah, I'm doing it right now. Gay. Oh shit, I just hit the music. It looks like we are at 10:56. Sorry, I don't know what happened there. I got a new keyboard. It's a lot quieter than the old one. But my mouse is still clickety click click. So if you hear that, then that's, yeah, my mouse. Oh, if you're wondering why my game's rendering slow, it's because I'm recording to the same hard drive. And a hard drive that's actually on the verge of dying. So it's, you know, the game, it does access the hard drive. While playing the game. I mean, when it's like trying to load the map, such as looking a certain direction has to load it. While if you have a good, okay, he did not. The light was green, because I saw it on the cross sign right there. So, anyways, yeah, that's causing recording. That also brings down frame rate. I'm not getting near as much frame rate as I do off camera, which is about in the 60s. I'm getting in the 40s and 30s right now, but anyway, so yeah, that's why the game's loading slow. I can't do anything about it. I gotta get a new hard drive, obviously, because it's reading and writing. It's writing the video file, which is basically creating it, as well as writing the maps for the game. Well, no, it's reading from the hard drive to load the map up, but. I mean, that's why it's a little slow, and I have my distances on, I think 50, and my view distance and detail distance on 50, but as you see, still doesn't, like, it doesn't look like it because of the map not loading, so, yeah, can't do anything about that, so, for now, I'm gonna get a new hard drive later and just use that as, for recording only, as well as rendering. Yeah, I don't want Brave Hearts. It's not working. It's like, oops, code 4. Like, it works, and then it just like, and it crashes my game more often than any other mod I had. So, decided to just fuck it for now. And yeah, just do regular LCPDFR callouts. So it's probably gonna be long because of the lack of GTA 5. So, yeah. Gang unit. Yeah, I was a little lazy on the license plate. I didn't bother to get rid of the Liberty because I thought that was okay. So, yeah. And I don't know why I get like a rush responding to calls. Like, I was watching some police responding videos, like a collection of it. And damn, it just looks so epic because of the, you know, lights and sirens going through intersections and, you know, going by cars and shit. But, yeah. I just get a rush when I'm responding to a call inside the game. Of course, it's nothing near to as real life, but still, this is like the second best option. This mod. LCPDFR. This came a long way. I actually joined it only about a year ago. Year and a half. So, yeah. You know, GTA 4 came out pretty late for the PC. So, like, I think 8 or 9 months after the Xbox and PlayStation release. So, GTA 5 is most likely going to be the same, but... if it's not, hopefully they do a good job on it. Like, you know, so that it can run good the way it's supposed to be on PC. Because, technically speaking to them, I exceed the recommended requirements. Like, they only recommend a dual core. I have a fucking 6-core. As well as a 512 megabyte graphics card, and I have a 1 gigabyte. So yeah, clearly, technically to Rockstar, I'm supposed to be running it maxed out with graphics mod and so on. But because of being poorly optimized, it requires you to have like something 10 times stronger than like an i7 or so to like run it maxed out, or an i5 and stuff. So yeah. Yes, even Intel's struggles, some people struggle running this game, even if they have the same PC, because this game's just so poorly optimized that it's like luck of the draw. It's like it'll either run smoothly for you, or it won't. So be it. That officer passed a red light, but I can't do anything about that. What the hell? Why is it taking so long for a call? Let's just do a shots fire, because gang unit. Why not? Let's pull up right here. God damn it. Yeah, noose. I want them to kill him. Motherfucker. Officer down. Calling the medics, and no medics available. Paramedics are en route. So yeah, let's wait for them. I think that was them. I think they just passed by. But yeah, whatever. Waiting the new LCPDFR comes out. I don't know when though, but hopefully, yeah, but it'll definitely be better than ever, because of, you know, they took the version right now, 0.95's RC2 has actually been out for over a year now. I'm not sure year and a half, but definitely over a year. And you know, people are enjoying it, but you know, some people are getting sick of it because of some of the bugs, but that's okay, because 1.0 is gonna come out soon. So yeah, that's awesome. Visual textures are nice. Too bad you can't have the entire city, most of it, but not the entire city, covered in these nice black roads. So yeah. I don't know, I actually wonder why. Some of the roads are replaced by something other than the GTXD. So, yeah, the GTXD is just like a partial part of this. I mean, most of the city. I'm just guessing, because every GTXD covers most, but not. It's always the same roads. This road that I'm driving on now, as well as Union Drive West and East, which is on the left and right sides of Algonquin, which is the island I'm on now. So, yeah. Look at that water, it looks nice. If you're wondering, I'm using Visual IV because it makes the game run smoother off camera. not so much. Recording's always going to be the same because of the condition of my hard drive and so on. I already explained that. So, yeah, but off camera, the frame rate's it's a lot better than it is now. That's how I get 50 and 60. And as well as it makes the shadows look smoother. I believe that's what it's called. And the shadows are on very high right now. Everything else is just on highest as can be, texture, reflection, water. But view distance and detail distance, that's where it's like it uses more than it needs to be. Like 25, I mean, to run at max settings at like 100 view distance detail, I believe you need a 2GB graphics card or a graphics card that's over 1024, which is 1GB of graphics memory. That's just what I've read about and stuff. So yeah, about what features actually uses more than 1GB of memory. Right now with my recording software, I can display how much it's using. It's using 645. Yeah, that's more than the recommended, what the Rockstar recommended the graphics card to run it maxed out according to them. But yeah, poor optimization. Hopefully GTA 5 will not be like that. These calls are taking way too long, but we ran a red light.
I order you to stop that vehicle!
No.
Pull over now! You have been warned! Pull over! Now!
Okay, this works.
Wanna find out how so many people fall down the stairs in my precinct?
What?
Thanks.
Alright, let's see who we got here. Brian Ortiz. Stopped 3 times, no citations. Interesting. Oops. Well, we'll give him citation since this is his first citation. I'll go easy on him, just give him $40. I don't know why it was turned that way. Domestic. Let's go code 2 on that. Which is no lights and sirens, but they're there immediately. So, yeah. Because I don't really deem these code 3 necessary. And yes, I know you can turn right on red. And, as well as the officers who police my city, I was actually involved in a domestic dispute. Well, I wasn't directly involved, but I mean, I was there when it happened, and it was classified as a domestic dispute, but it wasn't like somebody had like a gun or a knife or anything, so, but they responded there, code 2, they got there immediately, but when I didn't hear any sirens off in the distance, so the lights weren't on, and I was actually looking out the window waiting for them, and three of them came in. And they parked up right on the side of my house, but yeah, they were all just calm and casual. None of them were like rushing with their guns out or anything. So yeah, that's why I say domestic disputes are more of a code 2 and not really a code 3 situation. You know, not a situation where police officers have to get there like as fast as they can. Motherfucker, you hit a woman, you bitch. How you? Put your hands up. Yeah, it's called transport, and let's wait for him. You know, I always forget that you can go through this area in this little thing right here. This little entrance. So, yeah. Putana. Yes, sir. Can I help you? Okay. Alright, there they are. That's the Chevy Caprice you will be seeing. See, I'm either going to use that next video or the Taurus. So, yeah. Because both the Taurus and the Caprice are pretty good looking cars. And I'll save the Crown Vic for last because it's my favorite. And I think it'll be a good way to end the Scrubs Police Department officially. Not just for me not making videos, you know. Yeah, let's get a shot fired. Hopefully, ooh, shoot him. Okay. Motherfucker. Yeah, why not? I just got back from work. Definitely going to be watching GTA 5 videos. While I'm in this video, you know. So far, I've seen one video so far. That's from the App Store. I'm sure there's more to come, but like, those aren't much views, and it's been out for about 4 hours now. So, that means that yeah, most people are in school. You know, the teenagers and stuff who watch her videos, as well as the adults are probably in work, at work, so, yeah. Yeah, let's wait here in front of fire station. I'm sure they don't mind. Mugging, why the hell not? I feel like I've done more traffic stops than I have anything else, so. That's actually, more than call out, so that's actually the first. I usually never do that much traffic stops. I'm trying not to force them out, but I kinda had to, because it's not say I'm busy, but it's just taking so long to call out. It's usually caused by the script hook DLO that LCPDFR replaces and stuff. So okay, 1057 Fox. When it's replaced by something by another version of it and stuff. When I did that, it made it so when I called news, the game would crash. But then when I don't replace it, with the one that I did, and I just leave the original that LCPDFR put, I get, it doesn't crash when I call noose anymore, but, wait, is a station nearby? Yeah. I left him here. I meant to bring him with me. I forgot what I was talking about now. Oh yeah. But then I replaced it with the EOS V7 one, because that's actually a newer version of it than the one LCP-DFR installs, and I guess it made it so callouts don't come out, even if you're not set to busy, but at least it still doesn't crash. At least my game doesn't crash when noose is called. So that's good. Buddy, let's go to buddy, not my buddy. Alright, let's go. I don't wanna go to that. Yeah, let's slow down a little bit. I'm gonna go to the one up here. Sorry, I like it. No, I've actually never noticed this place, but police cars actually do spawn here. Right here, the building on the right of me, because it's like I guess we can take a quick stroll. Yeah, sometimes police car spawns right there. Or over here, I forgot where, but it's actually really, I don't know, it's just a cool little area I found randomly when I was playing multiplayer. And sometimes police officers can be seen guarding it. We should just give him an anti-aliasing, because the edges of everything is like jagged. If you don't know what that means, don't worry about it. But hell yeah. Alright, we're actually gonna go force call a pursuit, and then that'll be it for, oh, perfect. Oh, you know what we can do? Oops. Yeah, let's just keep trying to pull somebody over. And then we will, alright, this car seems okay. And then we'll, I don't know if there's a key to force a pursuit open. Let's check. Let's see. Nope.
I order you to stop that vehicle!
Okay. I actually did it by accident to press shift tab to close it, but it's a one pursuit.
Send in some backup. I need backup ASAP.
Alright, let's make this a very long, interesting pursuit. No, come on. Alright, she died. What the hell? A56, we're code for her. Look at that. Different variety of cars. Crown Vicks, Caprices, Dodge Charger, me. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next video. Later.